pi by 2 and the values is cos 4 theta by 2 into sin theta d theta. And when we are integrating it directly, we are getting its value as cos 5 or 1 by 5 directly, and it comes out to be 32 pi a square by 5. So this is the value of the surface area. Now in this case, when we have this cardioid equation, we have discussed the surface area, volume, length and the area of the curve. In most of the heart surgeries, we are using this equation as a model of the heart, and with the surface area, volume and length and area, we are able to do the operation. And with this, because already the program is in the computer with the model and simulation, and with the length of this, we are able to calculate the by the angiography the how much depth we have to go by calculating the value of the A parameter. So this is a simple model equation, R equal to A plus 1 plus cos theta, which represents the modeling of the heart. And by this section of the heart, we are able to visualize each and every portion. And since area is with us, length is with us, volume is with us, and the surface area of this, so we know the entire heart movement. And with that, we have the contraction and the extension stage, and through that we are easily able to calculate the portion where the block is in that, and with the depth or the value of A, by controlling that we are able to calculate all the parameters, and with that we are able to do the heart surgery in a simple and simplified manner nowadays, instead of doing the earlier long and the bypass surgeries. So now in this way, totally it is a revolution in the field of the medical sciences also, with the calculation of the all these parametric curves and the equations or the modeling equations. Now in general, when we are taking any curve, so this means whatever formulas or reduction formula we used, simple manner, those created a revolution in the history by calculating the surgeries in a different forms by using the computers in a simulation or in other manners. So now today we have discussed about the application of the integral calculus, or the what is the application or the main importance of the integration. We have discussed today about the area. Area of the curve means we are finding that how much is the area is the in between of the curve. So when we have to find out the area of the curve, it is about any axis. Suppose a Cartesian curve is given, y equal to fx form, and we have to find out the area about the x axis. In this case, if we have to find out the area about x axis, the area is simply denoted as integral a to b of y dx. Since y is a function of x, so when we are substituting that function, directly we are getting that as a function of x, and we are getting the value of that. Now suppose instead of that, curve is given in the form of x equal to fy. This means the limits are given, or the we have to find out the area of the curve about the y axis. In that case, area comes out to be directly integral from c to d of x dy. Since x is a function of y and these are the limits of y, so we are able to calculate the area about the y axis. If instead of x or y, it is a parametric form is given, this means x is either a function of t and y is also a function of t, which is a parameter, then we are taking directly the integral as either y dx or x dy, whatever be the case of that. But the limit, instead of x and y, we are taking the limit of t, and dx and dy we are calculating in terms of t. So the total function is function of t, and we are calculating that function. Now if a polar curve is given, then directly we are taking a area as half times of integral r square d theta, where r square means the limits are in terms of the theta. So this is the way we are calculating the area of the curves when we have the different forms of the curves. Now if we have to find out the length, length means we are finding the perimeter. Perimeter means we are finding the how much is the simple length of that or the thread is required to cover that curve. So when we have to find out the length or the perimeter of any curve, simple we are calculating the integral of ds. Ds means the length or the specific perimeter of that curve. For finding that about the x-axis, this means y equal to fx curve is given, then ds means the length of tangent we are using, and the directly we are getting the integration of integral from a to b of under root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square into dx. When we have to find out the length about the y-axis, then we are taking it as under root of 1 plus dx by dy whole square into dx and integral of that between the limits of x. If we have to take the parametric curve, then we are taking the length as integral of dx by dt whole square plus dy by dt whole square under root of that into dt, where we are taking the limit as the parameter with respect to t. If the polar curve is given r equal to f theta, then the length or the perimeter is given as integral of under root of r square plus dr by d theta whole square of d theta. This means the parameter or the total function is a function of theta, and we are integrating that with respect to theta. So this is the way we are calculating the length or the perimeter of the curve when the curve are given in different form, either in a Cartesian about x axis or Cartesian about y axis or parametric curve or a polar curve. Now we come to the volume. Volume is the revolution of the curve about any axis. If it is about x axis, then we are taking volume as a simple integral a to p pi y square dx. If it is a revolution about a y axis, then it is a integral c to d pi x square dy. Now if it is a polar curve, then y is dx, y is r sin theta, and dx we know that we are easily able to calculate dx by d theta by taking x as r sin theta. R cos theta, x is r cos theta and y is r sin theta. So accordingly we are calculating the curve equation. So if we have to find out the volume about the x axis, it is simply pi y square dx integral of that between those limits. If it is about a y axis, then it is the integral pi x square dy about those limits. But if we have to find out the volume of the parametric equation, means x equal to ft and y equal to some function of t, then we are using the same formula. Instead of y, we are putting the function of t, and instead of dx, we are taking dx by dt and calculating accordingly if it is about x axis or about y axis. If it is a polar curve, then simply we are using as per the formula either about x axis or about y axis. But whatever formula we are using there x as r cos theta and y as r sin theta. So if it is pi y square dx, we are putting y as r sin theta. R is the function of theta. So total comes out to be function of theta, and dx as dx by d theta by taking x as r cos theta and r is in terms of theta. So total is comes out to be a function of theta, and we solved accordingly. Now we come to the surface area. Normally surface area is also a revolved the curve about any axis. So when we are revolving a curve about any axis, this means about x axis or about y axis. If we are revolving a curve about a x axis, then surface area is denoted as integral of 2 pi y ds. Ds means the length or the perimeter. So according to the curve, we are putting the value of ds and calculating it. If it is surface area about a y axis, then it comes out to be simple 2 pi x into ds. But the value is changing according to the curve and according to the axis about which we have to take it. Suppose we are taking a surface area about x axis, then the simple formula is 2 pi y ds. But suppose the curve is of the form y equal to fx, then the surface area is calculated as integral of 2 pi y under root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square into dx, and taking the limit of x from a to बी वी कैलकुलेट द सरफेस एरिया. इफ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द सरफेस एरिया अबाउट अ कर्व विच इज ऑफ द फॉर्म एक्स इक्वल टू एफ वाई, देन इट कम्स आउट टू बी 2 पाई वाई इंटू इंटीग्रल ऑफ 2 पाई वाई अंडर रूट ऑफ 1 प्लस डी एक्स बाई डी वाई होल स्क्वेयर इंटू डी वाई. इफ इट इज इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट इट इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ अ पैरामीट्रिक फॉर्म, देन द फॉर्मूला इज 2 पाई वाई वेयर वाई इज ऑल्सो वी आर पुटिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ द पैरामीटर इंटू अंडर रूट ऑफ डी एक्स बाई डी टी होल स्क्वेयर प्लस डी वाई बाई डी टी होल स्क्वेयर इंटू डी टी एंड टेकिंग द लिमिट एज अ टी वेरिएबल एंड वाई ऑल्सो ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग एज अ फंक्शन ऑफ टी. सो टोटल फंक्शन कम्स आउट टू बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ टी एंड वी आर सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग दैट वैल्यू एंड कैलकुलेटिंग इट. इफ वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग फॉर द सर्फेस एरिया फॉर द पोलर कर्व देन इट इज सिंपली 2 पाई वाई इंटू डी एस मीन्स 2 पाई वाई इज आवर आर साइन थीटा. सो इट इज 2 पाई आर साइन थीटा इंटू अंडर रूट ऑफ आर स्केयर प्लस डी आर बाई डी थीटा होल स्केयर इंटू डी थीटा वेयर आर इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ थीटा एंड द लिमिट वी आर कंसिडरिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ द थीटा. सो इन जनरल वी हैव टेकन अ वन एग्जाम्पल विच इज इंटरेस्टिंग एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द मॉडलिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ द हार्ट विच इज आर इक्वल टू ए ऑफ 1 माइनस कॉस थीटा और सिंपल इक्वेशन आर इक्वल टू ए ऑफ 1 प्लस कॉस थीटा. सो दिस इज गिविंग द टू डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ द हार्ट एंड थ्रू द एरिया सर्फेस एरिया वॉल्यूम एंड लेंथ वी आर एबल टू कैलकुलेट द ऑल द पोर्शंस एंड विद द वेरिएशन इन द पैरामीटर ए वी आर गेटिंग द डिफरेंट वैल्यूज ऑफ द कॉन्टेक्शन एंड द एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ द हार्ट एंड विद दैट द पॉसिबल सर्जरी ऑफ एंडोग्राफी एंजियोग्राफी एंड अदर थिंग्स ऑफ द पॉसिबल एंड विद द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ दिस एंड द कंट्रोलिंग बाय द सिमुलेशन इन द कंप्यूटर मॉडलिंग. So this is the total application and the how to apply the integral calculus in calculating the length, area and volumes. In this is all about the differential calculus and the integral calculus we have discussed up to this section. In the next section we will deal how to apply these in the differential equations and in the different areas of finding the solution. Thank you.